Hi, I'm Randy Altman with Post Perspective. We're here with Dell Technologies' Matt Allard. Hello, Matt.
Hi, Randy. How are you doing? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Thanks for taking the time. We're here to talk a little bit about what might have been at Siggraph. I know that's all happening virtually now, and you guys have some things built around it. But let's jump into what everybody's talking about right now, which is remote workflows.
Yeah, this is a big thing for all of our customers in the M&E space that, you know, we went from, you know, actively in production and in post-production to having to figure out how to do that remotely. And so we've seen our customers go through, kind of some phases of this. I think we've all gone through phases with this pandemic, but particularly in this working environment. The first step a lot of our big customers did in the studios was to say, well, we can keep work going by shifting workstations to home. And so they would take the workstations, check them out, the employees would take them to their homes. But when you're talking about high performance tower workstations, that's often a lot, you know, for somebody's house or small apartment, and they may not have a good working office. So, you know, there were some stresses with that. And so we quickly saw an evolution to a mobile workstation. You know, we did have a big mobile workstation announcement in May, started shipping those recently in June. And those new mobile workstations are capable of high resolution workflows, 4K, 6K, 8K raw workflows in real time without transcoding. And so they're really practical for, you know, operating high-end workflows out of a remote location. And that could be on set or in production, but it also could be in somebody's house. So that was practical. But for the bigger customers, you know, the big studios, game developers, the challenge there was they're very protective about the security of their content and their assets. And so having equipment in the field and content sitting on drives in the field is not the best solution. So they started doing workstations in their data center and remoting those out with solutions like Teradici. And so you'd have a workstation in the data center and you could present that workstation out to one of their home-based workers using a lightweight laptop or even a Zero client. Dell makes these Wise Zero clients that are, you know, very lightweight, very small, and could give you that experience, you know, and let you run your applications remotely in a one-to-one kind of one workstation corresponding to one user. But what we're seeing increasingly, and I think, again, goes to the more efficient usage of the infrastructure, is actually one-to-many, virtualizing those workstations so one workstation can serve more than one user based upon the compute demands of their particular workflow. So something that's lighter weight may not need 100% of a workstation. It may need half of it. And so you could put two users for that half. So that's been, you know, kind of the evolution we've seen. And it's really a continuum. You know, customers will do what works best for them. I know that, you know, similarly, Vancouver Film School has, you know, had their students coming back and they remoted all of their new workstations. They have, you know, a whole raft of workstations, Dell workstations, and they remoted them so the students could get access and complete their homework since they're not going in class.
That's going to be the new normal. It sort of has to be. And I know there are other studios, and I know that you have a user who's doing motion capture but able to do it remotely. Is that correct?
Yeah, we have a really interesting customer, Cream Digital in Toronto, who does, they've done a lot of experimental work around digital humans and really making it more approachable at low cost. Obviously, doing high quality digital humans in the studios with big budgets is something that's amazing. They've been trying to approach it with a more, you know, cost conscious approach in mind, using photogrammetry techniques and kind of that kind of virtual environment. But the reality is, you know, nobody's going on to any kind of studio lot, including motion capture studios. And so they're working on inventing ways of providing motion capture in somebody's home office so they can get animation motion capture based on, you know, some innovation they've done there, and doing photogrammetry at distance. And, you know, the ability to kind of continue their work in that manner, I think, without putting people in the same environment and at risk, I think is pretty genius, and I think exciting to see. I do think that's part of what we're seeing with our customers in this climate is innovative thinking and creativity to come up with ways to keep working and keep producing interesting content. So they're a pretty interesting story. In fact, one of the things they're doing as a side project is VR representation of how to do the swab test, the nasal swab test, because they realized they're in Canada, they're with the Canadian Health Service, they don't have enough people to apply that particular test. So they're going to have to train a lot of people. And there's really good evidence that VR is a better training mechanism than anything you can do because you get a real physical sense of things. And that's particularly important, I understand, in terms of getting that swab to the right location inside somebody's nose. So really, really amazing idea. And I think an innovative use of VR in a place that we really need it.
That is very cool. Yeah. So we were talking earlier before we started the interview about some products that you would have shown at Siggraph, including one that is targeting animators. Is that right?
Yeah. So, again, we make workstations for all sorts of workflows in the M&E space, but the one that I think will start shipping right about when Siggraph's running, August 25th is when it'll be orderable, is a new ultra small form factor tower. And this is, it's tiny. It's small enough that it actually can fit on the back of a monitor Visa mount. So you can actually put it on the backside of a monitor if you wanted. But the exciting part about it is, it'll support, high performance processors, 64 gigabytes of memory, and most importantly, an RTX 3000 card. So as a kind of core animation solution for a studio or game developer where you want this great 3D interactive performance for modeling and animation, but you're going to kick things off to the renderer, the big render fire. This is a really ideal machine, and it's low power consumption. So putting a whole lot of these into a data center and potentially remoting them is really effective because less power draw means less cooling, less power consumption in the data center, which they're all concerned about when you start putting hundreds of these into the data center. So we think that's a really exciting machine. And with that kind of footprint, it'll be great for 4K video visual effects workflows. It's very similar to a number of the mobiles we just announced that are shipping. And those, I think particularly like the 5750 thin and light mobile is really similar characteristics. 10 core processors, up to an RTX 3000, up to 64 gigabytes. And those are already getting in customers' hands. We have customers doing raw 6K, raw 8K workflows straight on the machine without any transcoding. And that's incredible for mobiles. So we're pretty excited about these products. And we're sorry we couldn't show them in person because particularly like this new 17-inch thin and light I just mentioned, it's so unbelievably nicely designed. It's just great for people to put in front of it. But, we'll have some videos online. And as always, we'll be available to talk and answer questions for people as part of our Siggraph presence.
Great. Matt, where can people go to find out more about your mobile workstations and such?
Yeah, the best place to go to get the kind of basic overview is DellTechnologies.com/precision. When you go there, you'll get kind of a broad overview of workstations. Go down the page a little bit, you'll get more stuff on media and entertainment products, including our RTX Studio compliant mobile workstations, which I know is a big push in the space. People get a lot of confidence with NVIDIA's RTX Studio compliant machines. The other thing I'll mention is precisionworkstations.com. With workstations, we do certification with all of the software applications our customers regularly use, and we report out those recommendations at precisionworkstations.com. So if you're not sure how you should build a workstation for Creative Cloud, we can tell you that. We'll give you actually specific recommendations that have been blessed by Adobe, and we'll give you kind of a good, better, best kind of easy button for finding the right machine for you.
Sounds fantastic. Matt, thanks so much.
My pleasure. Really appreciate the opportunity, Randy, and look forward to seeing you virtually at Siggraph.